wants a lot of stuff from the Russia investigation declassified because he's been told by Nunes and others, the more comes out, the more it will look like you were framed. What's the risk there if a lot of stuff comes out? We've talked about sources and methods, but let me reverse the question. From your knowledge, is there anything that could come out that people would look at it and say, wow, I can't believe they ever included the president in this analysis. He and his people clearly did nothing.
There is some very, very serious, very specific, undeniable intelligence that has not come out that if it were released would risk compromising our access to that sort of information in the future. I think it would also risk casting the president in a very negative light. Would he have a motivation to release those things? It's almost incomprehensible to me that he would want that information out. I don't see how he spins it to his advantage, because quite frankly, I don't believe it's flattering.
You think there's more bad stuff about him that we don't know?
There is always more intelligence. There was a lot more in the intelligence community assessment than what was ever released for public consumption. I mean, the original version of that report was classified at the absolute highest level I have ever seen. You're talking about top secret, compartmentalized, code word stuff. And it would be tragic to American intelligence collection for those sources to be put at risk.
So that was Andrew McCabe talking about the evidence in the Mueller report, how devastating it would be to Donald Trump if the utmost classified information was released. And they're talking about this because Donald Trump is now saying that he wants all that evidence to be released because it's going to prove that it was all a hoax, right? That it was all a plot to overthrow a duly elected president of the United States. Funny that he would, you know, make that argument, because essentially what the Mueller report proves and why that evidence is classified so highly is that Donald Trump is a Manchurian candidate who was placed in the executive branch by Russians to undermine our democracy. That's why he's done nearly everything wrong, right? He has said everything that you would say if you wanted to divide a country. That's what he's done. And that's why he's attacking this election process as well. You know, people talk about he's being investigated, he could face jail time. He's also still doing the work of the Russians. He's still doing the work of the Russians because he will move to Russia after he leaves office. Same thing happened in Ukraine. Viktor Yanukovych, he was a Manchurian candidate for Vladimir Putin in Ukraine to get their resources. When the Ukrainians ousted him, he said he was going to take a trip to Russia. In Russia, he said, oh, my life is being threatened. The Russians said that they're going to protect me, so I'm staying here. That's why it's a running joke in Russia that Yanukovych and Trump will be neighbors, because Donald Trump is a Manchurian candidate for the Russians. No doubt about it. So the balls on Donald Trump to poke the CIA, poke the FBI by saying, yeah, you released that, knowing that they're not going to release this information. The evidence is so embarrassing to both Donald Trump and the CIA, because it happened, right? Say what you want to, but like, the Russians successfully placed a Manchurian candidate to attack our democracy in the executive branch, duped tens of millions of Americans into thinking a real estate mogul who only wanted to party was going to represent them, was going to represent the farmer and the guy, you know, the plumber. Right? Joe the plumber. Like, the balls on Russians and Trump. It's either balls or they're just completely drugged up out of their minds. And they're just like, this is all just so weird and so strange that, like, again, this real estate developer who's an old, like, let's face it, he's an old racist white guy who got his feelings hurt because he was embarrassed by our first black president, teams up with our foreign adversary, Vladimir Putin, who also was embarrassed by our first black president because the world rallied behind Barack Obama and looked at Vladimir Putin like, you're kind of a mobster, man. Like, and we need to kind of rally our efforts to keep you at bay. That they would team up. Like, the balls, the audacity on these people, either the balls or, like, again, the drugs in their head. Like, wow. So, I mean, what do you guys think about what McCabe just said? And what do you think about the fact that, like, does it surprise you at all that Donald Trump is throwing our CIA sources underneath the bus? Possibly they could die in Russia. And again, this proves that, like, we're still working, right? That the Russians may have won the battle, right, by putting Donald Trump in the White House, but, like, the war, like, it's still going down, right? And that's what this is a reminder of. That's what the past 4 years has been a reminder of, is that Russians are playing these stupid games and that we're going to have to just face them down over the coming decades until Vladimir Putin is gone. So, man, that was quite the video to see in my feed. And it just serves as a reminder. Like, guys, everybody who's been suspicious of Donald Trump, who thought, oh man, like, dude, did the Russians put him in power? Like, everything Andrew McCabe said there, it could devastate Donald Trump, right? It could put our sources at risk. The high level of classification. Like, Donald Trump's a Manchurian candidate, guys.